Hello and welcome to ITC TechShare. I'm Tom Grissom. In this episode, I would like to demonstrate the Smart Notebook version 10 software, and in particular, the Gallery Essentials. To begin, let's double-click on the Smart Notebook icon located on the desktop. This opens up the Smart Notebook software that is used in conjunction with the Smart Board. In the last episode, I went over each one of the tools of the toolbar and demonstrated what each one would do. In this episode, I would like to talk in particular about the Gallery Essentials, which can be located over on the left-hand side underneath the Gallery tab, which looks like a picture of artwork. If I click on the Gallery tab, that opens up a sidebar with two different panes. If you'll notice, on the top one, we have something listed as My Content, Gallery Essentials, Lesson Activity Toolkit, Gallery Sampler, and Smart Exchange. In this particular episode, I want to concentrate on the Gallery Essentials, so I'm going to click on the little plus symbol, which will expand my offerings. The Gallery Essentials is like PowerPoint clip art. You have a number of different categories, anything ranging from arts, English, geography, history, mathematics, spatial needs, and sports and recreation. Each one of the plus symbols means that you can expand the different choices. So, for example, if I want to see what's under the geography folder, I click the plus and it expands it to flags, landscapes, and maps. Each one of these has a subfolder. If you'll notice on the lower pane, whenever I click on a particular category, it brings me into three different choices. In this particular case, I have pictures, interactive and multimedia, and notebook files and pages. These are essentially categories or subcategories of whatever I have selected in the upper window. Let's say I'm doing a map unit and I want to find out what types of maps are available in the Gallery Essentials collection. I'll simply click the plus symbol here to expand my choices of maps. And you'll see we have all the different continents. Africa, Asia, Europe. We also have mapping symbols, North America, Oceania, South America, and World. So let's say that we'll be doing a unit on North America, and I need to find a map of the United States. So if I click once again on the plus, you'll see that I have a subfolder entitled USA. If I click on that folder, I have two further subfolders. So we're just drilling down to get to the particular detail that we want. In the lower pane, I have the category of pictures or notebooks, files, and pages. Since I want a map, I'm going to look at the notebooks, file, and pages. Now on the left-hand side there, all I did was click on the triangle to expand the choices. If you click on it again, it contracts it, so it's a toggle switch. Click on the little plus, and let's say here's my map of the United States. Just click, hold, and drag it from the left-hand side and let go. And now we have a very simple map of the United States. Now, in addition, I do have pictures up there, so let me choose the little triangle to expand my choices. And here are actual cutouts of the different states. So what you can do here, here's Alaska. You can bring over the different pieces. All I'm doing with the mouse is click, holding, and dragging, or if you're in front of the smart board on the room, just use your finger to click, hold, and drag the different choices here, Arizona, and so forth. So we can come through here and very quickly make a little interactive map. And I would highly encourage you to get the children up out of their seats and actually manipulate each one of these pieces and have them all take turns or make a little learning center out of this where they can get up and actually interact with the different pieces. To go back, I can just simply click the minus arrow and that contracts my different choices. Or let's go back up and find geography. So here's geography expanded. If I click this minus button, that will contract all of my choices. Let's say we were doing a mathematics unit. If I click the plus page or the plus symbol up here, this is the add page button, you'll remember from last time. Let's add a blank page here. So now if I go back to page sorter view, you can see here's page one, and now we're on a blank page two. So let's go back to our Gallery Essentials and let's look at mathematics very quickly. If I click the plus symbol to expand my different choices, let's say I want to go to statistics and probability. Again, I can look for different backgrounds, and this will be a very nice addition for math teachers. As you can look here, we have all kinds of different types of backgrounds for different types of graphing paper, everything from polar coordinates to the standard XY axis. So let's bring over the Cartesian coordinate system here. So here's an XY axis. And then you can just simply choose whatever you'd like. Let's choose the line function here. And let's say we're talking about slope of a line. So I can very quickly come up here and do an overlay of whatever lesson I'm giving here. We also have interactive and multimedia. Click on that. So here's die. Say we're doing a probability unit. So I can click, hold, and drag. Move that from the left to the right. And here's an interactive die. So I'll go up to my select button, and whenever I click on that, it is an animated. Since I am in interactive and multimedia, you'll notice the little red F, that stands for Adobe Flash. So this is a Flash component. You do need to have Flash installed on the computer for this to work. So I can randomly click here, and it will give me the different rolls of the die. All right, let's go back and let's collapse the mathematics choice. I just want to show you a little bit of variety. Let's make a new page. So let's go back to page sorter view, and we just added page 3. Let's go back to our gallery essentials. And in this case, let's look at science and technology. Let's expand that category. So I'll click on the little plus, and let's say we're doing a chemistry unit. So I can choose the different choices. And once again, on the lower pane, I've got the big broad categories of pictures, interactive and multimedia, and notebook files and pages. If I open up the interactive multimedia, you'll see I have various choices. These are all animations out there, changes of state, so going from a solid to a liquid, a gas, whatever. If I go back and choose my notebook files and pages, here's some examples doing a lab, just the different symbols here is a flask, a cylinder, a funnel, and so forth. So I've got these different choices. I also have periodic table examples. So there is an example of the periodic table. Or if you'd like the students to come up and fill out the different table here as a blank one that you can work on and have the students come up and enter the different categories. So let's say that I'm doing a unit particularly on the elements. So I've got an interactive periodic table, and here it is, and it gives me a brief set of instructions. And every time I click on a unit here, or I'm sorry, a different element, it changes. So you can see there's potassium, lithium, sodium, helium. It's giving me the number of protons, neutrons, and all the chemical properties of each particular element. There's oxygen. So a lot of good resources out there. Let's collapse chemistry. And just to show you the variety, it's got a lot of different things out there. Let's collapse science and technology. Spatial needs, if you're needing something with sign language, let's make a new page here. We have American Sign Language and British Sign Language. So if we open up the different pictures, here's the different letters. So you could drag the letter C, the letter, let's spell out a name here. So C-A, and then let's look for the letter T. So there's cat. And then you can also, because these are objects, remember from last time, we can make something larger or smaller and rotate them around. So you have the flexibility there to make things a little bit larger and a little bit clearer for the class. And then lastly, we'll conclude here with the gallery essentials. Let's go back to our page sorter view, and let's add another page. And now then, let's go back and we'll finish on sports and recreation. So many schools, you're involved in coaching, so if you need to have a background, you name the sport, it's probably in here. We have badminton, baseball, basketball, cricket, fencing, field hockey, football, gymnastics, lacrosse, volleyball, soccer, rugby, tennis, and so on. Let's say that we're going to need to do a football field, so the coach wants to diagram some plays out there. We can go to the football category. Go to our notebook files and pages, and here is the background of an American football field. So the coach could go up there and very quickly diagram the pages or the different plays and things that he would want to do. You also have the pictures here that you could put different players out there. If you don't want to do X's and O's, you can actually go out and grab the actual clip art and then move that around. Okay, so that concludes our demonstration of the gallery essentials. We can go back up here and collapse this down. The next episode, I will discuss briefly the different options available in the Lesson Activity Toolkit version 2.0. Until next time, this is Tom Grissom. Keep on learning.